Welcome to the channel Data Science Demonstrated. Estimated time to arrival, or ETA, is one of the most important predictive analytics which is used in apps such as Uber or Waze. In this video, I'll be showing you on how to use machine learning for predicting estimated time to arrival. The business use case which I'll be showing is related to ETA prediction for taxi rides. However, these techniques are applicable for any logistic related use cases. I'll be starting off with some cutting-edge geospatial data exploration. I'll be then showing you some advanced data preparation and feature engineering. I'll be also using deep learning architecture, which consists of fully connected and LSTM components. Now, do not worry if this word sounds too technical. I'll be explaining them simply with examples and visuals and without any complicated programming screens. You can also access a demo of some of the functionalities on my platform, experiencedatascience.com. Let me pass it over to my virtual AI assistant, which will talk more about this.
Hi, I will show how you can try out some of the functionalities which will be shown in this video. You do not require any coding skills, and you can run analytics in a ChatGPT style. You can also customize the analytics with your data. So stay till the end of this video, and I will show you how.
Our mission to calculate the estimated time to arrival is located in Portugal. The mission, if you choose to accept, is to calculate the travel time for taxi rides in the city of Porto. The data which we'll be using is the taxi location data. It has got the taxi ID, the taxi ride date and time, the from and to location in terms of longitude and latitude, as well as all the locations which are recorded during the taxi ride. Also, you have the time taken for the taxi ride. The machine learning task is to predict the travel time for a taxi ride between two locations. Once the travel time is predicted, the ETA is the start time plus the travel time. In order to develop a machine learning model to predict the travel time, I'll be going through the process which starts with data exploration, develop some cutting-edge features which can be used to train the model, and then use the model to predict the travel time. Let us start with data exploration. Whenever you have geolocation data, one of the first data exploration to be done is a geolocation heat map. As you can see here, that most of the data is related to the city of Porto. The red spots indicate high number of location points, meaning high number of taxi rides in this area. As our objective is to predict the travel time, a basic histogram can give a good idea of the statistical distribution. You can observe that most of the travel time are within 30 minutes. The reason we have the x-axis of the histogram going up to 960 minutes is because there are some very high values of travel time. These are the outlier values which we can verify with a box plot which is shown here. The usual travel time is from 0 to 26 minutes, and the outlier of 960 minutes of travel time can also be observed. I will later on remove the outlier value in the step of machine learning. This visual shows a scatter plot between the travel time and the hour. You can observe that the travel time are high between 12 hours and 16 hours compared to rest of the day. Now let us introduce a cutting-edge feature called places. We can divide the entire map into small squares. The center of each square is called a place. Let us now see on how this looks on an actual map. The square shows the area which I have taken to create the places. It corresponds to the city of Porto and its surroundings. When we zoom in, you can observe small circles which corresponds to a place. Once we have the places defined, we can assign actual taxi location to the nearest place. Each place can be given a categorical value such as P0, P1, P2, and essentially we are converting a continuous value such as latitude and longitude into a categorical value called a place. This will help us to make data exploration much more efficient. As an example, here is a heat map of the time taken between two places. The x-axis is the from place and the y-axis is the to place. And hovering over the colored box indicates the average time taken between the places. For example, the time taken from the place 1730 to the place 1678 is about 35 minutes. The place 1730 corresponds to Rue de Saujo 67. And the place 1678 corresponds to Quai de Gaia 21, which is on the other side of the Douro River. The travel time which you see is the real-time information shown by Google Maps, which more or less corresponds to our analysis. So the place is an important feature which will help us determining the travel times accurately. After feature engineering, we have a data set which contains columns such as day, hour, month, start place, stop place, and also the ride which is represented as the sequence of places as well as the travel time. The next step is to train a machine learning model on historical data which will learn the relation between the input features and the output, which is the travel time. The output of the training will be a machine learning model which can be used to predict the travel time for all the new taxi rides. Now there are various machine learning models, but let me first give you a background of the model which I've selected. Our data has got sequential data such as the sequence of places which the taxi goes through. We also have a non-sequential data such as the time and date of travel, the start and stop places. So when you have sequential and non-sequential data, one of the efficient architecture is a deep learning architecture which has got two main components. The fully connected layer for non-sequential data and an LSTM layer for the sequential data. Let us now see how these components look like. Here is a visual representation of the fully connected layer for the non-sequential data. On the left, you have the input neurons which corresponds to the non-sequential data and the output neuron which corresponds to the predicted travel time. The intermediate layer shows how the inputs are used to predict the output. For example, the intermediate neuron 1-3 and 2-2 are passing a positive signal shown by the thick green line to the output. And this means that these neurons have learned a pattern which corresponds to a high travel time. We can peek inside the neuron to see what pattern causes high travel time. For example, we see that a blue line for the hour, which is not too short and not too high, can cause a high travel time. And this would correspond to middle of the day, around 12 hours and 16 hours, which matches with our scatterplot analysis which was shown earlier. Similarly, we see a red line for the day which is not too short and not too high can also cause high travel time. And this means that all the days at the beginning and the end of the month can cause a high travel time. Now let me move to the next component of our machine learning model for the sequential data. And this is the LSTM layer, which stands for long short-term memory. And essentially it is used for sequential data, which in our case is the sequence of places which the taxi goes through. So here is a visual representation of the LSTM layer for the sequential data. On the x-axis, we have the LSTM neurons, and on the y-axis, we have sequence of places which have been identified by the machine learning model as the usual route taken by the taxis. Just a note that I am just showing a sample of LSTM layer. In actual, there are many more places than what which are shown over here. In this visual, the LSTM layer has identified the usual route between the place 17H2 and the place 1749, and it goes through all the places which are shown over here. Let us see how these places correspond on a Google map. The start place 1782 corresponds to Praça de Batalha, and the end place 1749 corresponds to Pestana Durero Riverside. And all the intermediate places are shown as white circles, and the blue lines shows the route which the LSTM architecture has identified as a sequence of places taken by the taxi. So the LSTM layer is very powerful, and it helps automatically identify the most common route between two places. The predicted travel time is then based on the common route between the two places. In summary, the fully connected layer identifies the useful features in the non-sequential data, such as the hour and the day, which can impact the travel time. And the LSTM layer identifies the sequence of places which are usually taken by the taxi rides. Here is the result of the complete machine learning model shown as an actual travel time versus the predicted travel time. The accuracy of the model can be visualized by this scatter plot between the actual and the predicted value. Now, generally we see that as the actual time increases, the predicted value also increases. The accuracy measure is the MAE, or the mean absolute error, which is around 2 minutes, meaning the model can predict the travel time with an error of 2 minutes compared to actual, which is in fact a very highly accurate model. Here is a visual representation on how the model can be actually used. The model itself can be on the backend server. The app user can enter the start and stop location, the date and time of travel. An API call can be made to the model. The model will then take all the non-sequential inputs and feed it to the fully connected part of the model. And it will take the start and stop place and feed it to the LSTM part of the model, which will then give the most common route between the two locations. And based on all these inputs, the model will then give a predicted travel time and the ETA and return back the information to the app. So my friends, let me now pass it over to my virtual AI assistant, which will show you on how you can experience the functionalities which are shown in this video on the platform experiencedatascience.com.
Hi, I will show how you can try out some of the functionalities which will be shown in this video. You can start by logging in. Then go to create your own experience. Now you will see a list of datasets which are available in the platform. You can select taxi_data_porto.csv, which has sample data related to taxi. Select it and copy it to your data. In a while, the dataset is available for you. Do the same for taxi_data_porto_location.csv, which has the location data. You can also upload your own data into the platform using the Add button. For now, select the taxi_data_porto.csv. And then click Analytics. You will see a prompt where you can type in name of analytics. Type in data, histogram, box plot. Make sure that the analytics are separated by a comma. Now hit Run. In a while, you will see three tabs. Display data, histogram, and box plot. Select Display data to see sample data. You can select Few records to show, and select All columns. Click Run. And in a while, sample data is displayed. You will see trip ID, date and time, as well as travel time in minutes. You can now make a histogram of travel time. So select column for histogram as travel time in minutes, select hour as tooltip, which is additional information shown on the histogram. Click Run. In a while, you will see histogram. Please note that the data available is only sample data, and not the complete dataset which was used earlier, so histogram looks different than what was shown earlier. You can do similar analytics for box plot, which can be useful to analyze outliers. Now you can go back and select dataset, which has location data. Type data, geospatial heat map in the prompt, and click Run. You can analyze the data using the Data Display tab. You will see data has latitude and longitude of taxi rides. Now go ahead and run the geospatial heat map. Select the fields for latitude and longitude, and click Run. In a while, the geospatial heat map will be displayed. With this, I will conclude the video. Hope you have enjoyed watching it.